Here's three really useful strumming patterns for acoustic guitar. I'm going to demonstrate each pattern, then we're going to break it down, and then we're going to practice it together by taking it from a slow tempo up to a higher tempo. We're also going to be practicing these patterns on just a G chord. We're not going to worry about any other chords for this video. So here's pattern number one. So this first strumming pattern is often used in folk music and is quite often referred to as a train beat rhythm. So for this pattern, we are emphasizing the offbeat. So that means we're emphasizing the 2 and the 4. So if I play it for you slowly, we're going like this. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. So you may have noticed there, I'm only strumming the full 6 strings on the 2 and the 4 are emphasized beats. So on the other strums, if I'm strumming down, I tend to just strum these bottom 3 strings. And if I'm strumming up, I tend to just strum these top 3 strings. If you focus on doing that, you'll notice that most strumming patterns that you're gonna play are gonna sound better and also feel easier to play. So we're gonna practice that together now. We're gonna start off slow and then we're gonna build it up to a higher tempo. Okay, so now here's strumming pattern number 2. Okay, so for that strumming pattern, we are playing down strums on the 1 and the 2, and then we're playing up, down, up on the and, 4, and. So if I do it slowly, it's going to sound like this. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. Okay, so again for this pattern, you'll notice that I'm not playing all 6 strings each time that I do a strum. So if you start getting used to this concept that if on a down strum you only strum, say, the bottom 3, or you can sometimes include the G string as well, it doesn't really matter. If you only hit these strings on a down strum and you only hit the top 3 or 4 when you do an up strum, it's going to give a lot more space you're playing and it's going to make things a lot easier to play as well. So again now we're going to take a G chord, we're going to start off slow and we're going to build up that strumming pattern to a higher tempo. Okay, so lastly, here is strumming pattern number 3. So for this pattern, we're hitting a down strum on the 1, and then we're leaving a space until the 2 and then we come back in there and just continue on for the rest of the bar and a half that's left. So if I do it slowly, it's going to sound like this. 1 and 2 and. So you'll notice again in this pattern, probably more so than the others, I'm only strumming the higher strings. So probably from the D downwards, so D, G, B, and E, on most of the strums except for our very first strum. So we're just going to take that G chord again. We're going to start off slow and build it up to a higher tempo. Last tip for strumming in general is try to use both your wrist and your arm when you're strumming. So we don't want to be strumming like this with just our arm, and we don't want to be strumming like this just with our wrist. If you use both your arm and your wrist, you're going to have the best chance of getting a fluid sounding motion when you're strumming. Anyway, thank you for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, give it a like, subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you in the next one.